Hi, everyone. It's Bob Perkins bringing you another Monday Morning Sales Minute from our inside sales studio here in Arizona. I'd like to welcome Bryan Burrell. Bryan, how are you?
Good to be here. This Arizona weather is amazing compared to New York, I'll tell you that.
Well, Bryan is from New York. In fact, he's my brother-in-law. He visits Arizona, and we had a great conversation last night about a lot of things, the coronavirus situation in New York, but we were talking about working from home, and I mentioned that a lot of our members are, because of coronavirus, are working from home, and you've been doing it for a long time. Bryan's the pastor of a church in Cottage Valley, New York, just outside of the city, where he's been the pastor for 35 years. In addition, he's worked with government, both local government, on school boards, and you've been a leader in different areas, and you're going to share some thoughts about this thing working from home.
Right. Well, the reality is when I first did it, I didn't do it very well. My mindset was, let me just go to the kitchen table. But my wife thought I was home, so she would engage me. The cats knew I was home, and they wanted to love me. The kids thought, well, Pop's home today. So I couldn't do that. I had to find a space. So I've got a place that I dedicate to doing working from home. I have to have a mindset that says to me, I'm going to work. I start early, I'll get some steps in, get my shower done, get dressed, and then I begin. It is dressing for success, starting early, and having a mindset that says, I'm going to work.
Well, here we are in my home office, which is the studio. And by the way, I'm glad you showered this morning.
Oh, yes, I did. Yes,
but
I needed it.
And getting your steps in, in other words, going for a walk outside, how does that help prepare you for the day?
Well, I find that it works better for me than coffee. So okay. I'm there. I get out. I've got a good start. I want to have a certain number of steps for the day. And so I've already accomplished something. I'm in accomplishment mode. And then I'm like ready to go.
So you mentioned a couple of things. Dedicated space, number one. Mm-hmm. Number two, prepare yourself physically and mentally, so your mindset.
Yep.
What about, do you ever need to take a break because it's your home where you do family living as well? Do you ever need to take a break during the day, and what do you do?
Well, I tend to take the break as though I would do it at work.
Okay.
Limited in time, focused, and go right back after that, because if I am not in a dedicated space, and if my mind is not on work, the distractions of the day, the distractions of family will creep in, and all of a sudden, my priority has shifted. And it's not work, it's something other.
You might grab lunch, go eat it somewhere else. You may go out, pick up lunch, that kind of like you would do at the office. Let's talk a little bit about technology. It's great that we now have different modes of communication. Mm-hmm. You have to communicate to your church members, especially thinking a little bit about now, the coronavirus, that could affect you, how you communicate to your congregation.
Absolutely. Just 7 miles from us, the state of New York has put a quarantine and has shut down houses of worship. I have to figure out, what if that happens here? How do I continue to feed my congregation during the course of a time like that? And part of it's going to be going to a dedicated space, making sure my mindset is on church, providing the people what it is that they need, and not allowing the distraction of a containment to stop the work of the church.
So the leaders that are watching this, that their reps now may have been used to all coming together in a common space, now they're working from home. Any tips for the leaders in, you know, how do they communicate? What do they communicate if now their team is not there in person?
Mm-hmm. Well, clearly we've got the video capacities that are there face to face. I'm going to make sure that I do a video of my sermon and then make it available. Send out the information that here it is. Encourage people to listen. Maybe even have them do some homework as a feedback that they really listen.
So stay engaged.
Absolutely. Stay engaged. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Trying to make sure that they know that I'm working right there with them, spending time with them. It actually can be a really good thing.
Right. That's good. You're not necessarily there micromanaging in their face.
No.
So this is, I like this, leadership lessons from a pastor.
Yes.
Any final thoughts before we sign off at all?
I think that given the reality of our world and given the reality of this virus, given the reality that more and more people are working at home,
yeah,
we need to make sure we're prepared.
All right. So don't just wing it.
No.
All right.
Not wing it.
Bryan, thanks so much. And hope you enjoy the rest of your vacation
out here.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.